Okay, now we'll see the next question here. Summation k is equal to 1 to 2n plus 1 minus 1 whole power k minus 1 k square. Okay, if I expand this summation, I'm going to get here, if I put k is equal to 1 minus 1 whole power 0. So first term will be positive. So I'll be getting alternating series here. Okay, so 1 square minus 2 square plus 3 square minus 4 square plus and so on. Okay, 2n plus 1 whole square, because minus 1 whole power 2n will be positive, right? So I can write like this. Now see that it contains alternating series. So I'll separate the positive terms and the negative terms. So I'll get this as 1 square plus 3 square plus 5 square, okay, plus and so on, 2n plus 1 whole square, like this. Then I'll write the remaining terms with minus signs separately, okay? So 2 square minus 4 square plus 6, 2 square plus 4 square plus 6 square plus and so on, 2n whole square, like this. Okay, now see that this is in this we have some missing terms, like we don't have the even numbers, right? And here 2 square, 4 square, 6 square, okay, here those terms are missing. So I'll add and subtract, okay, 2 square plus 4 square plus 6 square plus and so on, 2n whole square here, okay, I'll add and subtract. So therefore, this particular series will become 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus and so on, 2n square plus 2n plus 1 square, okay, like this, then minus. Now here, because I subtracted here, I added here, then I have to subtract also the same term. So I'll have two times of this. This is one time and this is one more time. So therefore, I can write two times of 2 square plus 4 square plus 6 square plus and so on, 2n whole square, like this. Okay, then this is equal to, okay, here, when we have sum of first n natural numbers, we wrote this as, okay, n into sum of the squares of the first n natural numbers. We wrote that as n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6, right? So here we have the last number as 2n plus 1. So we have to start with that. Okay, in place of n, we'll have 2n plus 1. In place of n plus 1, we'll have 2n plus 2. Then in place of 2n plus 1, so I'll have 2 into 2n, okay, plus 1 plus 1, okay, by 6 minus, okay, 2 into, from the series, okay, just like how I have done the previous problems, I can take out 2 square common from this. So I'll get 1 square plus 2 square plus and so on, n square, okay. So on solving this, I'll get this as 2n plus 1, okay. So from this, I can take out 2 common. Then I can write here 2 into n plus 1. On solving this further, I'm getting that as 4n, okay, plus 2 plus 1. So that is 4n plus 3 minus 8 times of. See that here again I have 6 in the denominator, then minus 8 into sum of the squares of first n natural numbers. I can write it as n into n plus 1, okay, 2n plus 1 divided by 6, like this. Okay. Now we need to solve this further. Okay, so what I'll do is, from this and this first term and the next term, I'll take out n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 common. Okay, so I'll do that at the top. So I'm taking out n plus 1 common, n plus 1 common, and 2n plus 1 common. Okay, and here I can cancel 2 and 6. So I'll get in the denominator as 3. So I'll get here 4n plus 3 divided by 3 minus 8 by 6. If I cancel, I'll get the answer as 4 by 3 into, okay, in this I took n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 out. So I'll have only n here. Okay, so like this. So from this, I can cancel clearly 4n by 3 minus 4n by 3. So I'm left with, okay, 1 here, right? You can observe 4n by 3, 4n by 3 will get cancelled, 4n by 3 and here 4n by 3 will get cancelled. I'll have 3 by 3 as the answer here, that is 1. So therefore, the answer will be equal to n plus 1 into 2n plus 1. So this is the right answer for this. Okay. Then we see the next question. Okay, n cube plus 2n is divisible by, okay, which of these numbers? Okay, here we need to use that is n equal to 1, 2 and so on, so that because we have to do that fastly. Okay, we cannot make use of the mathematical induction, all the steps here, right? As we need to do that fastly, right? So if n is equal to 1, I'll get here 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3. If n is equal to 2, I'll get 2 cube, okay, plus 2 cube plus 2 into 2, that is 4, which is equal to 12, okay, and so on. You can observe here, each of these is divisible by 3, okay? 3 is divided by 3 and 12 is also divisible by 3. So therefore, I can say that the answer for this is equal to 3. The next, this is the direct question which you have learnt already, okay? X power n minus a power n is divisible by x minus a for all positive integers, or we can say for all natural numbers, right? X power n minus a power n is divisible by x minus a for all n belongs to natural numbers, or we can say positive integers. Okay, this is the right answer. Next, for all n greater than or equal to 1, which of the following is divisible by 9? Okay, you can observe on seeing the first term, we'll attempt to write that 8 power n plus 1. Okay, but you know that x power n plus a power n, okay, is divisible by x plus a, where n is only odd integers, okay, odd positive integers. You have this statement, right? You know this. X power n plus a power n is divisible by x plus a only for the odd positive integers, okay? So therefore, we cannot use this as the option, okay? First one is the wrong option, okay? Now we'll see here, 4 power n minus 3 n minus 1. If I put n is equal to 1 in this, so 4 minus 3 minus 1, which is equal to 0. If I use n is equal to 2, 4 square is 16, 4 3 is 12 minus 1, okay, which is going to give 16 minus, okay, here, 4 power 2, 16, okay, 3 into, sorry, here, 3 into 2, sorry, here I wrote 12. 3 into 2 is 6, okay, 4 power 2 is 16, 16 minus 6 minus 1, which is equal to 9. So from this, you will get the clear idea that after this also, the terms are going to be divisible by 9, okay. 0 is divisible by 9 and 9 is also divisible by 9, okay. So therefore, the option B is the right answer for this, okay. 4 power n minus 3n minus 1 is divisible by 9. Then we'll see the next question. Just now I discussed, right, that a power n plus b power n is divisible by a plus a, okay, a plus b, where n is a positive odd integer, okay, only for positive odd integer. Now see that here, 2 power n minus 1 is odd positive integer, right, for all natural numbers. 2 power n minus 1 will become odd. So therefore, just now I wrote here, it is divisible by a plus b when we have n as odd natural numbers, right? So therefore, I can say that as the powers are odd, I can say that a power 2n minus 1 plus b power 2n minus 1 is divisible by a plus b with that particular note. Okay. The next, here we have a n is equal to 6 power n minus 5 n, okay? So, when divided by 5, what is the remainder it leaves? We need to check, okay? This also can be done by using n equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on, okay? So, here if I put n is equal to 1, I'm getting 6 minus 5, so which is equal to 1, okay? It is leaving the remainder as 1, okay? If I see that a2, okay? a2 is equal to, here 6 square, that is 36, 36 minus 10, which is equal to 26, okay? When divided by 26 when divided by 25, I'll get here 25 and it leaves the remainder as 1, right? So, if I continue like this, when divided by 5, when divided by 25, it leaves the remainder 1 in all the cases. N equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3 and so on, you can check that when divided by 5, when divided by 25, it is going to give the remainder as 1. Okay, then the next, the remainder when 7 power n minus 6n minus 15, okay, when divided by 36. If I use here, again in the same way we need to check, when n is equal to 1, 7 power 1 minus 6 minus 50. Okay, what is going to give the answer here? 7 minus 6 is 1, 1 minus 50 is minus 49. If I use n equal to 2, 7 square, so 49, right? 6 into 2, 12 minus 50. Okay, minus 50 plus 49, so minus 1 minus 1 minus 12, so that is going to give minus 13, right? So I can write this minus 49 as 36 into 2, 72, okay, plus here 36 into 2 with minus sign. Okay, I need to put here minus sign because I need negative value there, right? Minus 49. So 36 into minus 2 is minus 72, minus 72 plus 23. Okay, minus 72, I'll show you here. Minus 72 plus 23. So from 12, okay, it gives 9. Okay, here 6 to 49. Right, minus 72, so that gives minus 49. So I can express minus 49 as 36 into minus 2 plus 23, because that R should be positive. Right, R should be greater than or equal to 0, and it should be less than modulus of that particular number 36. Okay, so here, again, this can also be expressed as, okay, 36 into 1 with minus sign plus 23. You can observe here, minus 36 plus 23, it is going to give the result as minus 13. Okay, so therefore, I can say that here in this case, remainder is 23. Okay, if you are doing that with the procedure, it will become very lengthy. Okay, you need to check like this so that you can do that very fastly. Okay.